It's a ghoulish get-together in the Lancaster Lebanon League where Wilson and Penn Man are slugging out for Section 1 supremacy.
A terrifying rivalry. Can the best team in your county stay undefeated?
And a monster mid-Penn matchup between Trinity and Susquehanna. The Halloween edition of Football Friday starts now.
You're watching News 8 Football Friday!
Fans, fans, cheerleaders, this is News 8's Football Friday.
You're looking live at the fifth quarter for Conestoga Valley High School. News 8's Pat Principe is with the Buckskins in Lancaster County tonight. And News 8's Mike Straub is with the Northeastern Bobcats. He'll have more on their big matchup. And I am fearless Felix Baumgartner. At 24 miles in outer space, ready to make history, I'm going to skydive, break the sound barrier, and land in WGAL's Football Friday studios.
How about that, huh? Evel Knievel's got nothing on me. What a way to kick off our Halloween edition of Football Friday. I'm fearless Felix Baumgartner, and we get things kicked off with a whopper in the LL League. For that, we check in with Pat Principe in Lancaster County.
Okay, welcome to Conestoga Valley. This is the Loyola Worship Center, and I am your friendly Big Bird. That's right, Big Bird. You may have heard certain political candidates want to get rid of me, so I figured I better learn another trade. And what better trade than Football Friday host? We've got the Conestoga Valley football team here.
Yeah.
They're fired up. The cheerleaders are here. I like cheerleaders. They're so full of spirit. And we have a great game to lead off our highlights with you. Penn Man are 8-0 for the first time in team history against Wilson, the reigning kings of LL Section 1. They've won 34 straight games coming in. Will this be the Comets' night? Let's see.
Penn Man are cheerleaders rocking that Halloween look. The Comets trailing Wilson 7-0 to start the third. Late in the period, Bulldogs with a third down. The pass across the middle to Javon Young. He's got room and he's got moves. 73 yards all the way down to the Penn Manor 7-yard line. First play of the fourth quarter now. It's Junior Joseph bulldozing his way in, and Wilson leads 14-0. 5 minutes to play. Bulldogs at the Comets 1 trying to put it away, but Manor with a big fourth down stop, and the Comets have life. Fourth and long now, and it's Adam Saad rolling away from the pressure and then throwing it up for Adrian Verud. He's got it. First down at the Wilson 8-yard line. Fourth and goal now, and it's Saad flinging it again. This time Brett Caggiano in the corner. Manor's down 14-7 with 2 minutes to play. They recover an onside kick, and then Saad rolling and throwing and looking, and it is caught. No, it's picked off by Jim Brooks, his second interception of the night. Wilson survives 14-7. The Bulldogs with their 35th straight Lancaster Lebanon League Section 1 victory.
Wow, what a game that was. Wasn't that a great game, kids?
Yeah.
Do you guys know your ABCs?
Yeah.
ABCs?
ABCs, yeah.
ABC?
ABC, EFT, HIJK, L. Wait, is that what it's asking?
Oh, they're good. They're really good. All right, we're going to have more from here in a few minutes. But now let's go back to a guy named Felix and back in what we call the mothership.
Thank you, Big Yellow Bird. We continue in the mid-pen. Susquehanna playing its biggest game in 17 years, the Blackhawks in a first-place showdown against Trinity. The Shamrocks trying to take advantage, playing on their home turf. Third quarter, Trinity leading. Brett Morrison drops back, lets it go deep. Right there is Evan Miller, 61 yards on the catch and dash. And the Blackhawks are back in the game, down only two. Shamrocks on their next possession. Adam Geiger takes the pitch, makes a super cut, and he goes 9 yards to Pater. Trinity back in front. But now watch on the ensuing kickoff. The Blackhawks' Evan Miller fields the kick on his 11-yard line, goes straight up the gut, And watch the burst of speed as he just outruns everyone. He's not going to be denied. 89 yards for the score. Anita only down by a field goal. Back and forth they go. Trinity's turn now, driving at the Blackhawks' 14-yard line. The pass over the middle is picked off by Susquenita's A.J. Peck. And here we go the other way, down the sidelines, cuts to the middle. He goes 84 yards. Susquenita leads it 25-21. What a game. Fourth quarter now. Trinity's Boguski doesn't get rattled by that earlier interception. He throws across the middle to Brandon Kuntz, who zooms down the far sidelines. And is anyone going to catch him? He races 47 yards for the touchdown. Trinity knocks off Susquenita 28-25 in an absolute thriller. All right, now let's check in with Mike Straub in York County.
Yes, Mike Hostetler, it is true. Little known fact about me, I was actually a replacement referee in the NFL for the last couple of weeks. It was a dream come true. I answered an ad on Facebook looking for referees. I knew I liked football. I knew some of the rules. It was a lot of fun. I got to be as close as ever to my fantasy players. I spent most of the time walking over to coaches saying, you might want to challenge that one. I was hardly paying attention. But, you know, that's just life for a referee. It's been an awfully tough night walking around in these stripes. In all seriousness, I got to thank Ted Thompson and the guys at the Lancaster Lebanon League refs for lending me my get-up tonight, because it's been a – I have new respect for those guys. Getting a lot of dirty looks when I walk around. Now, also time to get serious about the play on the field tonight. Northeastern and West York. Winner of this game is guaranteed at least a piece of the York Adams Division II title. It's time to see how it went down right now. Northeastern and West York. Tied at 14 at the break, early third quarter. Hand off to the Bobcats. Dan Adams goes around the outside, and he's got a lane. There he goes, 87 yards. He's pulled down inside the five, which turned out to be huge because the Bulldog defense forced a fumble to keep the game tied at 14, which they also do on the next Bobcat possession. Kyle Narber delivers the hit, knocks it loose. Bulldogs recover inside the 10. Leads to this, Anthony Trone on third and goal. 4-yard touchdown. West York grabs the lead 21-14. Still in the third, West York forced to punt. Nope, forget about it. They fake it. Zach Smith, the Brock Snellbaker. Second successful fake punt of the quarter. They would punch it in a few plays later. It's 28-14. Late fourth, Northeastern desperate for a comeback. But Snellbaker is there again. Picks it off. He's gone for the touchdown. West York wins 35-14. They are 9-0 and clinch at least a share of the Division II title for the sixth straight year. That's how the Bulldogs do it. That's how they get it done despite the refs, whether they're doing a good job or not. 9-0. Fellas, 9-0. How does that sound? They also lock up at least a share of a division title, so congratulations, gentlemen. Let's get some of these seniors in here, guys. First, how's it feel to be 9-0, man?
Feels good, man. We work hard all summer. We do what we have to do, and pays off.
There it is. Brandon Kinneman, quarterback. Jump in here, man. You guys, two touchdowns in the first half, at least a share of the division title. To get it done tonight in this field, this game, what was the key?
The key is obviously up front, like it always is, and then the big guys up front, they did it again for us on the offensive defensive line, and then that's why we went 1-0 tonight for 9-0, and that's all that matters at the end of the night. That's sweet.
9-0 section champs once again. Got to be thinking big picture, fellas. District is just around the corner. Does this team have what it takes to make a run?
Yeah!
Oh, there it is. You hear it one more time, guys. Let's hear it. Let's get loud.
Yeah!
Football Friday. Bulldogs getting it done. Hossie, back to you.
Time for him to throw the penalty flag there. More from the mid-pen. Two of the biggest heavyweights in the conference, Cumberland Valley and Harrisburg. CV getting fired up for the second half. The Eagles were at home, but they were trailing come the third quarter. Harrisburg comes out strong. Kyle Cook can't find anyone open, so he tucks it and takes off down the left side, and they stop him just shy of the goal line. A couple plays later, he finishes the drive with a QB keeper. Cougars in command, 27-7. The Eagles would answer on 4th and 8. Ben Fernbach finding his tight end Tom Darcy for the first down inside the 5. And a couple plays later, Tyler Hartzell around the right end dives in for the touchdown, but it wasn't enough. Harrisburg scores an impressive win on the road tonight, 34-14 over CV.